The Detroit Pistons start a four-game road series on Wednesday night in Dallas, so a win here tonight at the Palace over the Portland Trail Blazers was a must. In the NHL playoffs, game one of the Eastern Conference Finals tonight in Pittsburgh. Penguins facing the Lightning. A church in downtown Detroit is looking to the Big Guy to give the Tigers its first win of the season. To college softball in the Big Ten tournament, top seed Michigan facing Indiana tonight in the quarterfinals. The Pistons will look to keep their offense rolling as they take on the Mavericks on Wednesday night. At the Palace, Kaitlyn LaBedz, Fox 2 Sports. Good evening, everybody. I'm Kaitlyn LaBedz, and this is Sports Works. Game two of the four-game set between the Tigers and Orioles in Baltimore Friday night. And for Justin Verlander, it was another opportunity to show the doubters that he can be dominant again. Runs were hard to come by in this one. Tigers had two on and one out in the second, but Chris Tillman got Jose Iglesias to ground into an inning-ending double play. But game still scoreless. On the other side, Verlander looked just as strong as he was last Sunday against Texas. The Orioles managed just two hits in the first five innings. JV was just mowing them down, got Manny Machado twice on strikes, but he made one mistake, and it was that pitch to Adam Jones. Just crushed at the deep left center in the bullpen. Solo homer gave Baltimore a 1-0 lead. Now Detroit had some chances late. Castellanos doubled the lead off the seventh, but after two strikeouts, James McCann sent this one to deep right, not quite deep enough. And in the ninth, last chance for the Tigers, Justin Upton hits it hard, but it was right at Mark Trumbo. That one run was enough for the O's to get the 1-0 win.
Obviously, we're frustrated. It's tough, especially when...
To college softball in the Big Ten tournament, top seed Michigan facing Indiana tonight in the quarterfinals. And the Wolverines just dominated this one from start to finish. The big blast came in the second inning. A three-run shot by Kelsey Sisala put them up 7-0. They went on to win 10-0. Michigan will take on Penn State in the semifinals Saturday afternoon. NBA playoffs, game six between the Raptors and Heat tonight in Miami. Goran Dragic led the way for the Heat, scoring 30 points as they began to pull away in the fourth. Then Dwayne Wade took over, driving to the hoop as Miami took a 12-point lead. Then, with under 2 minutes to go, Wade again. Nice crossover, hits the jumper. Wade with 22, and the Heat force a game seven on Sunday with a 103-91 win. All right, in the NHL playoffs, game one of the Eastern Conference Finals tonight in Pittsburgh. Penguins facing the Lightning. Pittsburgh a heavy favorite, but that's why they play the games.
Carried back ahead and a 3-on-1. It's Palat moving in for Drouin. It's a goal. And it becomes a 3-0 Tampa Bay lead.
Tampa built a 3-0 lead and held on to win it 3-1. But the Lightning lost starting goalie Ben Bishop to a knee injury. No word on how long he'll be out, but Tampa has a 1-0 series lead. Game two in Pittsburgh on Monday. And golf, second round of the Players' Championship. This is Will Wilcox on the famous 17th hole, firing at the Island Green. Takes a couple bounces and right in the hole for a hole-in-one. Wilcox just fired up, even jumps on his caddy. What a great moment for him. First ace on 17 in 14 years, and he's only the sixth player in 35 years to hit a hole-in-one during competition. Oh, and did we mention it's his first time playing in this tournament? That's a look at sports. I'm Kaitlyn LaBedz. Now back to you. The Detroit Pistons start a four-game road series on Wednesday night in Dallas, so a win here tonight at the Palace over the Portland Trail Blazers was a must. The Pistons have struggled offensively in their past two contests, but tonight they shot 52% from the field, scoring in triple digits to top the Trail Blazers 123-103. Coach Stan Van Gundy has more on his team's performance tonight. The Pistons will look to keep their offense rolling as they take on the Mavericks on Wednesday night. At the Palace, Kaitlyn LaBedz, Fox 2 Sports. It was a crucial win tonight for the Michigan Wolverines against the Northwestern Wildcats here at the Chrysler Arena as their season is coming to an end. A church in downtown Detroit is looking to the Big Guy to give the Tigers its first win of the season. They want you to come and leave a prayer for the team. A 9-foot prayer wall has been set up at St. John's Episcopal Church. It's expected to be dedicated today. This coincides with the annual prayer service for the Tigers before the start of the regular season. Opening day is Tuesday in Miami. The home opener is Friday against the Yankees. If you're a huge Tigers fan, why not live in a house of a heavy hitter? Miguel Cabrera's house in Birmingham is up for sale, but it comes with a hefty price tag, $2 million. The home of the Tigers' first baseman is nearly 5,800 square feet. He's reportedly looking to move to a house twice the size along Lakeshore Drive in Grosse Pointe. You're watching Fox 2 News Weekends. Stick around. We have more coming up after the break.